common question that comes up in the workshops is around triggered state changes, where users want to create more of a subtle or soft transition between each of the state changes. So by default in Storyline, when you trigger a state change, notice how abrupt it is, right? It's a very quick change, and in a lot of cases, that's going to work perfectly well. But there are other cases, there are times when you want something that's a little bit more natural, a little bit more a softer fade between the two, something like this one. So I'll click on this. And so as I go through each of the characters, notice that there's that soft crossfade animation between each of them. Feels just a little bit more natural. And the same thing on the timeline. So if I select the timeline, there's a simulated conversation between the two. Each of the states is subtly blending in to the next. So how do you do it in Storyline? Well, it's a fairly well-documented, been around since version 1 technique slash hack, and that is animated button states. Let's take a look at how that works. So I'll jump back in here to Storyline. We'll start with this first example where we have the static states. The characters, each of the characters has a series of states, and using the triggers, we are changing the state of each character, two triggers per button object, to change the state of each character to one of these default states, one of these custom states. Cool. That works naturally. The way it works is we need to create an animation on the characters, but you'll notice if you've ever tried this before, go into states, edit states, that by default, Storyline doesn't enable the animation options. And that's by design, so that's how it's supposed to work. But if you wanted to create that animation, you need to do one simple little extra step, and that is to select the object, Control X, or you can right click and choose cut, and you want to cut the object, in this case it's a character, cut it to the clipboard, don't do anything else, and then paste it. Now once you've pasted it back on the slide, back in the states, we're still within the editing of states, you now have access to the entrance and exit animations. So that's how you can apply those effects. And each time these states are shown or triggered, right, so it moves from one state to the next, the exit and entrance animations will apply. So I just go through each of my custom states here, select it, Control X to cut it to the clipboard, Control V to paste it. I now have access to my animations. And I can change the duration for each of these. It's a good idea to keep them all even, because then the transitions from entrance to exit looks the same between each object. But those entrance and exit animations will fire each time the object is shown and hidden, right? So even time when we click a button to show a new state, we're also hiding the previous state. So that's how you get that exit animation as well as the entrance between each of the characters. Is it a little extra work? Sure it is, but most people aren't going to take the time to do it. So for those designers like you who want to take a little extra time, that effect, that payout, is usually worth it, because it's an effect that you don't usually see in most projects, but your clients will notice it, other pro designers in Storyline will also notice it, and it doesn't take, you know, really that much extra time to create that subtle transition between the two. All right, so let's look at one more example, and that is something like simulating a conversation on the timeline where you want the characters to fade in. You could use the animated button effect that we just showed right here, right? We could put all the states inside, all the character poses inside of different states. But I think for a little bit more control, an easier approach would be just to use multiple objects. So in this case, right, the characters are simulating a conversation. I'll pull this up one more time just to like take a look at it. So as the timeline moves, you can see the seek bar down here. The characters fade in and out between different poses. And if you had some, you know, chat clouds going on and some other text on the slide to kind of show the conversation, that would work. I think in this case, it makes a little bit more sense to separate the objects, because it gives you a little bit more control between when they appear. So the idea is you're going to have multiple characters, right, with the different poses. You kind of have to think out, you know, what it is you want to show. And then as you stagger them on the timeline, you're going to apply the entrance and exit animation. So for example, this one right here for Lily 2, we have a fade in and a fade out. Notice how the fade out's a little bit faster. That's just a design choice I made. I think this should be the same for all of them, right? So the fade in is at a 3/4 of a second, and it exits at a quarter of a second. So the idea here is I'm aligning them, right? So that's going to be an important consideration, is to make sure that they seem like they're natural, right? You don't want them jumping back over too far or something like that. But using the, you know, fading in and out, but then controlling that time on the timeline, controlling them as separate objects on the timeline, gives you just a little bit more control over that, over each character and when they come in. Now, nothing to say, again, that you couldn't use the animated button states with all the character poses in here, and then use something like a cue point on the timeline that says change the state of Lily to state 2 when the timeline reaches cue point 1, change the object Maryland to, you know, state something when the timeline reaches. So you could easily do that if you wanted to put them all inside of the single object. And there's a couple ideas for smoothly transitioning objects with triggered state changes in Storyline 360.